Hey guys, we're at the beach today for this episode. My wife Gina.
Morning!
And me, Jim. Good morning. We're getting ready to go out on the beach. As you can see, it's a beautiful day. About 75 is the high today. A little bit of wind, but low tide's going to hit us about 2:13. Well, stay tuned and we'll get back to you. Alright, today we're going to be using the Excalibur 2. This is my beater machine. Normally I hunt in the water. I use an 800 Excalibur. I love it. My wife's going to use the Equinox 600. You've probably seen on our last videos. Bear with us. We're just starting the camera thing, and beach looks good. It's still high tide, and you can see there's some scallops started. Get out here and do some hunt. Stay with us.
Good morning. So we've been out here for a few minutes and I just got my first signal. It's a super solid 10. I really like 10s because, well, 10s can be gold or whatever. I'm going to go ahead and dig it up here and I will let y'all know what I find. Oh, look at that. I got it on the first scoop. That's exciting. Well, let's just see if we can find it here real quick. Interesting. Ugger bug. Yeah. See that? But it is some aluminum foil. So that's why I call this beach the Canslaw Beach, because that's a lot of what we find here. Is a lot of hands law, but it's all good. We get it off the beach, keep somebody from cutting their feet. So anyway, I will check back with you hopefully in a few minutes. Hopefully we won't be as bleak as we were last weekend. That was pretty bleak. But anyway, we'll get back with you.
Alright guys, I've been hunting probably about a half hour. Got my first good tome right here. A couple bottle caps, a pull tab. A good mid signal. That's foil. Yeah. Alright. So far, penny, bottle caps, pull tab. Wife's over there. She seems to be digging a lot. I don't know what she's finding, but. Check back with her in a little bit. I'll let you know when I find something. So, stay with me.
So I got a couple of signals here. It's 18, 24, 16. It's a little bit bouncy. I tried backing it off to check the max theory, as I like to call it. And it's not nulling out, and I'm not getting any negative tones. So I don't think it's a bottle cap. I'm going to guess, and I guess very badly. I would never bet on me. I'm going to guess that I have a dime and a nickel in there, but I will pull it up and let you know what I find. All right, so remember how I said don't bet on me? Yeah, I was right. Don't bet on me. But I am going to try another theory that my husband showed me. I already dug it, but I reburied it because I wanted to show you guys this. My husband liked to aluminum cans. There's a lot of aluminum cans on this beach, and it wasn't nulling out. Well, of course it is now, but so he says you're getting kind of bouncy. If you raise your coil up, and you're still getting the same real high tones. I don't know if you can see right there. But I am a good 8-10 inches off the soil, and it's still doing a solid 21-22, and it's saying it's about 6 inches down. Well, I'm already like 8 or 10 off the ground, so you get down there. Yeah, it is an aluminum can. Like I said, I dug it, and then I put it back because I just wanted to show y'all, kind of, because that can be frustrating. You get a solid tone, and you're digging and digging, and all of a sudden you pull out an entire aluminum can. You're like, dang it. So anyway, entire aluminum can, Bud Light. So anyway, that is just kind of a little bit of trickery that my husband showed me for aluminum cans. So kind of help you out a little bit. No false expectations there. So anyway, I'll let you know when I find an actual target. So hopefully we find something besides this today. So finally, my first decent target of the day, coming in at a lovely 13. Should be a nickel by all rights. It's not super deep at all. Come on, I know you're in here. There it is. Y'all can see that right there. I like that sound. Ding, ding, ding. Little clink in the bucket there. Just a nickel. Nothing special, but it's my nickel now, and it's the first thing I got today. Been out here probably a good 45 minutes, and all I've gotten is a bunch of cans lost so far, so I'll take a nickel. I'd be happier if it was a buffalo nickel, but you know, we don't find those out here. So anyway, I'm gonna fill my hole up and move on, and I will keep y'all posted.
All right, guys, metal detector here. Got my good first signal, and it looks like to be an earring, might be silver. Looks like a skull. It looks like a skull with some gems in its eyes. Kind of cool little thing, but pretty cool. I'll have to clean it up and show you guys what it looks like. Pretty awesome, actually. Sensitivity, I've got a 7. I'm getting a lot of interference from the electrical over here, so I gotta turn my sensitivity down a little bit. Screaming HM1. I'm hunting in dis mode. Rich Holt's just barely audible, but yeah, skull earring. Looks good to me. It's a keeper. Alright, just cruising around here. Got a good high tone here.
Definitely like a solid 7. It's a really nice signal there. I'm gonna dig it. It says allegedly it's down 6 or 8 inches, somewhere in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and dig it, and I will let you know what I find. I'm getting down there, and it's still like 7, 8, 9. So it's pretty solid. On digging. And so after that lovely deep hole, I ended up with this piece of can slaw. A little disappointed it did ring in at a solid, you know, it was solid. It was a 7, and the closer I got to it, it bounced between like an 8 and a 9, but it's just because it's all wadded up like that. So anyway, a little more can slaw in my little pouch there. Hopefully we'll find something not in the can slaw food category soon. I shall keep you posted.
Right, I got a really good signal there. Let's see what we got. what it is, crap spoon. Like the door. The door to crab net, crab spoon, crab basket, whatever you call it. Oh. Pretty deep. Take your holes, fill your holes. Alright, we're in the wet sand. A little bleak today. There's something you don't see all the time. I need a little slight embarrassed about it. He's wearing a thong. Seriously. He's wearing a thong. He's gotta be like 80 years old. The whole day out here. See a warship coming in. Sailboats over there. Beep boat. All the buoys for the crabs. There you go. Oh, gotta get that out of my head now. Oh my God. Really? You must not be from our country, huh? Nobody in their right mind out here would be caught in something like that. Especially at his age. Oh well. It's America. Everybody does what they want to do. Hey, there's my beautiful wife. Over there. Looks like she's on to something. That dog doesn't want to go in the water. Like, no. Alright. I'm sorry?
You find anything besides plastic?
I just pick up the trash as I go along.
That's great.
Yeah. A couple coins. A silver earring. About it.
Well, that's
beautiful.
Good, isn't it?
It's beautiful out here though.
It is. It's a nice day today.
It is pleasant. Look at this little dog. A little tiny thing.
I have a cat that's twice that size.
Yeah, she's little. She's like 8 years old, but she's just
you fit my scoop. Well, like, I don't need a leash. That's funny. That's funny. Well, I told my wife to bury her hole. She's an animal. Yeah, it's the little kids out here playing. They can dig as deep as holes they want, but the second we leave a little tiny hole open, scoop size, oh, we're in trouble. Look at this hole. Yeah, right. Like somebody can't fall in that, hurt their leg or something. Yeah. Oh. Because we metal detect, if we leave something like that, we leave our rights to lose our rights to be on the beach. Crazy. It's a slow day. Not a lot of coins. A couple dimes, penny. I'm excited about the skull. The earring and silver I found. It's pretty nice. Water's almost warm enough to be in it. In a wetsuit, I've been sick, so I haven't been in the water at all. Found a couple of rings last week in the dry sand. 10K, men's band. Irish wedding ring, silver, 925. Pretty nice. A little soft sand here, a little hard sand. Let's go out in the water a little bit and see what we got. Normally I use an 8-inch X-Cal, either pinpoint loose. My scoop's 9.5 inches, so I usually get it on the first scoop. Targets are scarce today. That's my wife. Aren't you hot? Getting hungry? Want to take a break?
Yeah.
All right. Head back to the car. What do you got? What's your numbers?
16.
16?
Yeah, but it's not going out.
Oh boy, interference off that on my X-Cal.
Huh?
Getting interference off yours on my X-Cal. Little tide's going out. Definitely. It's supposed to be a minus 0.01. Not much. Oh, let's head back and get some food. There we go. Ah, look at this hole. It's huge. Yeah, they get away with it. Actually, I think that's a hole my wife dug. She pulled a pull tab out of there. It's funny. It's starting to come out. Look at all these depositors. Tide's low. Looking good. Alright. Well, we're going to head in and take a break. Something to eat. Touch back with you later.
Little dude out. Little sniper dude. Look at that. Anyway, I'm just going to take this home. I got a little man at home that has a whole friggin' bucket full of these little guys. So he will appreciate one more to his collection. So anyway, CJ's not a total loss. Now the army dude. So boop boop. Dude, just point me to the direction of the jewelry. Beep, beep, beep. Just kidding. Anyway.
Wow, some style. She's in a hurry. Could have taken your time. Could have taken your time. Nice and shady under this pier.
Yeah, it is.
No targets, though.
So fun story. I was digging a hole, and you know how I can kick stuff around for like an hour. So I dig this really deep hole, and I'm getting like a 16, 15, 18, 16. But it's not nulling out, so I don't think it's a bottle cap. So I keep digging, and sure enough, I get it, and I get it out of the skid or out of the hole, and so I kick it to the left, and it goes to the left, and I look for it, don't find it, so I kick it to the right, and it goes to the right. And anyway, after about 20 minutes of kicking it back and forth, literally, and also confused because like it's definitely there, and then it's definitely not. Anyway, I finally break out my pinpointer and I find these five little musket balls right here, and I kept literally kicking them back and forth. So anyway, I never would have found them, but you know, I have my little pinpointer and I just finally got them all out, but I walked away from it because there's a lot of people over there. So anyway, musket balls are fun. I don't know. I think that's what they're called anyway. Anyway, I'm going to drop these in my bag and see what else I can find. It's an amazing day out here. Got some boats. Got a lot of people on the beach, which is great because they're all using sunscreen and, you know, whatever. So, anyway, I'm going to keep on digging, see what I can find, and I will get back with you. So, I have another target here. It's coming in at a 20. I'm going to guess that it's a penny. I found a couple of them here in this little area. Whatever it is, I got it in my basket, so, or in my scoop. Ha! All right, let's take a peek. Hold on. I lied. Yes it is. It's right there. And it's a penny. Yay! So, that's pretty cool because it's been a pretty super, super quiet day out here. Not a lot of targets, but definitely the scenery makes up for it. It is absolutely gorgeous out here, so I'm pretty happy with that. And I do believe my honeyman's gotten a few targets today, so that's a great thing. So we'll have to wait and see what he's got, but we're just going to finish up this beach here. We've been out here probably a good 4 or 5 hours, so yeah, a little tired. Generally by now I've had like I'm on like my sixth meal or something, but I've only had two today, so I'm kind of hungry. So definitely food is in line, but we're gonna finish this up and I will let you know if I find anything else.
Yeah, tide's out. I won't whip her. Dry sand to get around, walk back into the wet sand. Couple dimes, couple turns. Let's see what we got here. Still in that. She is. She's an animal. She's absolutely an animal. She's got. This for a while, we haven't had much targets. I'm gonna do a loose W. See if we can find a coin line, something. I don't know. I sound quite a bit. There she is, smiling away. Sometimes I think she'd outdo me out on this beach. A lot more stamina than I do. Look, I'm old. I'm getting old. Little Rottweiler puppy. Pretty good over here. Last time I was over here, I got 3 gold rings and 2 silvers in one day. Tide was low just like this. You got embedded rocks everywhere. It's coiled close to the ground. Let us leave. Surface fine. I've gotten 3 or 4 class rings out of this section I know of. A couple antiques, rings, gold rings. Lots of nice sea glass out of here too. Speaking of glass, let's get that bottle out of here before somebody gets hurt. Here we go. That's why we need more broken glass on the beach. One less bottle. Yeah, you wonder why there's so much sea glass. secret to this is just take your time. Keep the coil as close to the ground as you can without, you know, hitting it all well on the ground and banging the rocks. And just for them faint signals. Seeing a lot of big rocks over here. It's a lot of light stuff. A lot of silver coins in this section too. Standing walkers, buffaloes, V-nickels, VDs, Mercs. Got a lot of different coins over here. Oldest class ring out here is a 1969. Shut you off until I find something. Alright, well, we're gonna hit the dry sand on the way back. Not a lot of targets today. Our way back. Dismal day. Say hi to YouTube.
Hi.
Hi. My YouTube channel.
What do you do on your channel?
What's that?
What do you do on your channel?
We metal detect. Oh, it's pretty cool. Yeah, and this one's close as well. Pretty cool. My wife's over there, so her and I both do it. A lot of fun. Don't lose your jewelry out there. I'll find it.
Alright.
Have a good day. Well, we got a good high tone. Let's take a look. Probably shredded aluminum, maybe. Got it. And what do we got? Yeah, we got a penny. And one of many today. Yeah, let's see what we got.
Just did. Got it.
Scrap metal. Not sure. Looks like melted aluminum. Oh well. It's been that kind of day. pong. Right. Yeah.
The guy back there. He says, hey, I find anything I get half. I said, that's a deal. You drop that fat gold chain on your neck, I'll find it and I'll split it with you.
That's funny. Ah. Ice cream man.
I know, right? Keep seeing him.
Oh yeah, definitely. Ice cream man. I got a little sunburn myself. First sun of the year, really. I'm gonna turn this off.
All right, so we are home and all cleaned up. It's kind of our finds for the day. Mine was super easy, just some loose change, a couple of nickels, quarter. There's all those musket balls, my little cool little army dude there, and a random bolt. And then, of course, Jim's finds. He's got this chain, which actually cleaned up really well. It's just, again, it's plated. It's nothing too serious there. And then he's got this broken earring here, little pink doodad, whatever. The back's broke off. Some random coins. And then here is this little skull. It actually cleaned up pretty darn good. It's got definitely some little crystals there. My niece would love this. Oh my word.
It's 925 silver. It's
definitely the pretty find of the day there. So yeah, like I said, it was a pretty bleak day out at the beach. But that's okay because there were a lot of people out there and it was a beautiful day. So we did spend a lot of quality time together chilling on the beach. So anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to click that little subscribe button down there at the bottom. If you click that little bell right next to it, it'll let you know every time we post a new video so you don't have to be like, gosh, I wonder what Jim and Gina are doing, if they've done anything new. We'll just send you a little reminder every time it happens. So anyway, like, share, subscribe, and we will see you on the next hunt.